to you at home.
Joan, thank you so much for sharing the prophetic words by our Holy Father and his pastoral heart for war-torn nations, human beings so impacted, the gospel of life and standing for life at every phase and stage of life. Thank God we have a papa like that that stands up and speaks the truth in love. Father, it's always good to see your face.
Yeah, it's good to see you all too.
Another wonderful show today, the Bullets.
Praise the Lord,
wonderful, wonderful.
Amazing.
People. Yeah. Your reflections.
Oh, well, of course, like I said, a very impressive show today. And I want to share a story. I did meet Bill many years ago, and I was so impressed that he kind of left an impression on me at that time. This was must have been back in 2003 or 2004. We used to drive the brothers down there to Tennessee, and he used to give us our psychological exams. And so I would drive so that the brothers could be rested. And one day we met up with him, and we just spoke to him, and I think we had dinner with him. But all he talked about was his kids and his wife. And yeah, of course, you know, he said like their issues and things, but it was more about their talents and their gifts and the good in them and all of that. And this stayed with me all these years, you know, it was back in 2003, 2004, because here's this man who's so invested in his family. He didn't even really talk about himself or his practice, but it was just all about his wife and kids. And it's just, here's a man who truly loves his family, his wife and kids. And
I thought you were
still remember that.
I thought you were going to say you never forgot him because he made you do sit-ups and push-ups.
No, he didn't do that.
Okay, so it was more than that. It was bigger. Because he's known for that, too.
That would have been fun.
But that's such a beautiful testimony.
Sure, it sure is. It's just, but we talked, I mean, the theme of the show is sowing seeds, you know, sowing seeds. And you said something about that earlier. And so that's a seed there, you know. Sometimes I talk to many families, or men and women, or mothers and fathers, and they don't talk about their kids at all. But he did, you know. And this, it's a testimony to the family, is that they hang in there. You know, that's how you show great love, is that you're there. You're being there. I mean, you may not always have the right words and everything, but you're there. And that's what the kids need. They need somebody who's there, the mother and father.
I think the beautiful thing about parenting is there are so many intentional tasks that you have to do, bathing every day and making all these meals and doing the laundry, and you're kind of like, God, where are you in the midst of this, you know? And he's so near and close to us. We just have to say, Jesus, you're in the folding of the laundry, you're in the washing of the dishes, you're in all these little faces that come up to me and that, you know, call my name like a million times and you just want to change your name, stop calling me mommy, like, call me Frank, my name's Frank, I'm not longer mommy anymore. But those are the encounters of that beautiful child, mother to child, that then, and in a minute, they grow. I mean, your childhood, it happens so fast, right?